but it's not a pleasure to introduce my first commentary partner for the evening. He is the Best of the West Commissioner, Alexander G. Bernard. I know. You're right to boo, by the way.
Yes, we know. We know already.
Gravely disappointed in a lot of you. I go through all the trouble of setting up this show at the premier Las Vegas event, FSW Arena, and this is the best show of respect you can give me.
He's going to continue on like this for a minute, by the way. He doesn't tire himself out or anything. No, he can't. He cannot say toy boat 10 times. He's very rude. Doesn't even know how to operate the microphone. The button's on the bottom. It's right here, AGB. And what? Best of the West.
What I need all of you to do is stand on your feet, prepare your thunderous applause.
No, don't
for
stand.
The song of wrestling, Ricky Timmy.
Just when I thought AGB is at his most insufferable and it couldn't get any worse, here comes the songbird of wrestling, Ricky Tenacious. Why?
Why didn't I put him on commentary instead of you? It's an excellent point.
Oh my God, we're trying to.
He's singing.
Lots of talent, but they overlooked the one wrestler who did so much.
What?
Now the songbird's gotta let them know, yes.
I could dance to it.
You could dance to it when it was playing, but the songbird of wrestling, Ricky Tenacious, was just interrupted by the heartbeat, Nick Zander. Quite the familiar face here at FSW, Future Stars of Wrestling, where Best of the West calls home for tonight, where worlds collide. Nick Zander, the 2021 FSW Rookie of the Year, has heard just about enough, and I think just about everybody else in Las Vegas has too.
He's out here sticking his nose in this personal grudge of his just because he's never, matter of fact, never defeated Ricky Tenacious. So Ricky Tenacious was serenading us beautifully, beautifully, I might add.
Nope.
And this Nick Zander has to come out and make it all about him. He's just salty because he's a loser. He lost to Johnny Butabi. He loses to Ricky Tenacious.
I mean, that match hasn't happened yet. We're about to see it.
He's never beaten Ricky Tenacious. As
yet.
I understand
yet.
It, from talking to Mr. Tenacious, they've had quite a long-standing rivalry. And he has never, never once beaten Ricky Tenacious.
Do you want me to give them formal intros or what? Are we just going to make this an impromptu match or should I announce them? What do you want?
It's so fantastic. Best of the West is here at the FSW Arena. But I wonder if they brought enough custodians to put up a piece of trash in the audience. As a matter of fact, I see the biggest piece of trash standing in front of me, and then Nick Zander. But I'm the best around. No!
got... Hey!
Well, hang on a second. We've got a referee out here already, and I think the referee was kind of reading the Heartbeat's mind here. Heartbeat dressed to compete. Ricky Tenacious dressed like a disco ball after a bender. And we are underway our first contest here at Best of the West Worlds Collide. Ricky Tenacious serenading this crowd, kinda. And Nick Zander hearing just about enough. Referee Ben Hall in charge of this contest. And the Songbird missing wildly with that southpaw chop. And again with that haymaker. Gets fed the turnbuckle.
Where's the referee's count? This is in the buckle.
Oh! A big one sends the Songbird of professional wrestling careening to the corner. Up and over, lands on the apron. Well-placed forearm. A second one. Oh! Heads-up maneuver there by Ricky Tenacious, catching Nick Zander with the knee. And a clubbing forearm across the back sends him into the ring.
I think it was a splash. He calls that the Songbird splash
one,
cover.
Two, and a kick out at two.
But that's that heads-up maneuver, as you called it. That's that experience Ricky Tenacious has in fighting Nick Zander. Now, Nick Zander, we've seen extensively at Best of the West Wrestling, recently competing for our heavyweight championship, which, again, he lost to Johnny Butabi, our reigning defending champion.
Okay, well, Johnny Butabi has been doing this far longer than Nick Zander has. Nick Zander, the 2021 FSW Rookie of the Year, and Butabi, I don't know, 50 years in the business?
I mean, he's an impressive rookie, but a rookie nonetheless. And that's why he's falling prey to Ricky Tenacious in this assault on the back and the throat and that knee to the face. My God.
What? Well, okay, I was about to say Ricky Tenacious was looking downright vicious in the ring. Not after prancing around like he just did, though. More annoying than anything else, if I'm being honest.
You find him annoying. I find him quite charming. Not
I'm
quite
sure
as
you
charming
do.
As Biagio Crescenzo, of course.
Well, yeah, he might. Don't let him hear that you use that word to describe somebody else. He'll get jealous. Nick Zander, though, catching the boot and receiving a knee to the midsection for his troubles.
There we go. Ricky Tenacious living up to his name.
Oh! Forearm caught him right in the mouth that time. Hopefully hard enough that he will have to put his singing career on hold for the time being, at least for the rest of the night.
How rude.
We should be so lucky. You're rude.
Tenacious setting up for this big neck breaker. I understand it to be his finishing maneuver, but Zander trying to counter into a backslide. Ricky Tenacious keeping on his base, but
there's a cover.
Footing.
One, two. Two count. Oh, wait a second.
Went for a fisherman.
I think
suplex.
He pulled his ponytail. Oh my God, the force of that. Driving the heel of his foot into the jaw of Nick Zander, who is writhing in pain in the corner, may have cracked a tooth.
He calls that one the mic drop. It certainly put an end to Nick Zander's aspirations. Look at that.
Oh my God, why is the crowd singing along? Oh. Wait a second, there's a roll up. One, two, and a kick out at two. I think Nick
How
Zander
rude.
Had
I was
that.
Being serenaded, and Nick Zander had to break out in this wrestling match.
I'm sure if you hit him up on social media, he'd be happy to serenade you again, but he won't be serenading anybody after that German suplex. Oh, a flying forearm.
It's a challenge with this Nick Zander. He's so hard to beat, he's never safe dying.
Well, that's why he calls himself the Heartbeat.
He's going for this full Nelson. I don't know if that's a good plan against the larger Ricky Tenacious. Tenacious fighting out of that Fisherman Buster again. Goes into the corner.
Reverses the Irish whip. A pair of boots to the chest, able to create some separation. Rolls through. Xander has him hooked. Beautiful suplex floats over. He is not done. Gets him with the sky's end. One, two, and three.
Here is your winner, the Heartbeat, Nick Zander.
like it. I don't like it one bit. I should have put Tenacious on commentary, replacing you where he would have been safe.
Sorry, I had to ring announce real quick. What'd you say?
Tenacious should be doing your job where he would have been safe. Brave this Nick Zander maniac.
I didn't ask Ricky Tenacious to come out here and interrupt the show as we were trying to kick it off here. He did that on his own volition. Nick Zander was really doing what everybody in this crowd wanted to do, which was to come out and shut the mouth of wrestling's songbird, Ricky Tenacious.
Ricky Tenacious would have been singing ring introductions. Do you know how beautiful that would have been?
I can sing ring introductions if you want me to.
No, you'll sing them like Nickelback or
You're
whatever.
Damn right I will.
Damn you, Nick Zander.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Your referee for this contest, Cody Andrews.
Good to know you trained these monkeys as well. Irritable, ever entitled Wiseguy.
And ever in increasingly impeccable condition.
That cannot be denied, but my oh my, what an attitude and what a mouth. Man who will not stop getting in his own lair and blaming me.
And his opponent.
Reception for Damian Drake, a competitor who we've not seen in quite a while and has undergone, well, frankly, quite the personal revolution in the times that we've missed him.
It has been a minute since the Best of the West audience has seen Damian Drake. We most frequently saw him in tag team action as part of the Midnight Marvels. And dare I say, a little bit more grown up Damian Drake than when we last saw him.
We mean that not just mentally, but physically, you can tell. He added muscle mass, he added bulk, added size. Damian Drake in certainly the best physical shape we've ever seen him in.
He's definitely put on some size. I'm curious to see if his style will change it all as well. And we are underway, second contest of the evening here at Best of the West Worlds Collide. And another shout out to FSW, Future Stars of Wrestling, for being amazing hosts and allowing us to give everybody a little taste of what happens when worlds collide.
This is a matchup I was very excited to put together. Damian Drake, known typically for his high-flying styles, but in truth, he envisions himself as a very versatile wrestler, able to compete with any size, any type of opponent. And Wiseguy is about as versatile as they come himself.
Yeah, Wiseguy, the first and longest reigning Best of the West heavyweight champion ever in our near 6-year history. In fact, we are just less than a month away from year 6, our 6-year anniversary celebration, Saturday, March the 12th, Fresno, California, Best of the West Studios. It's going to be our biggest show of the year. We always have something special for the anniversary, and I'm sure you do as well, AGB.
But of course.
Tickets on sale right now at botw.tv/tickets, as Wiseguy backs Damian Drake into the corner, who wrenches on that headlock, not going anywhere, not just yet.
And I think that's a good sign of that improved size of Damian Drake, improved strength we talked about. I don't know that the Damian Drake of 4 years ago could have held on to Wiseguy.
Wiseguy going for that belly-to-back suplex, and Damian Drake again hanging on, like, I don't know. What hangs on to somebody's head and doesn't let go?
Ties?
Well, you can do it pretty easily, I would think. You have trouble with ties?
No. Anyways, moving on.
Okay.
Damian Drake, though, has held on to this headlock and certainly frustrating the Wiseguy. Wiseguy generally considered an extremely capable chain wrestling opponent.
Well, you mentioned it earlier, Wiseguy, one of the most versatile wrestlers on the entire roster. He is jacked. He is fast. He has uncanny athleticism, and you know it's only a matter of time until he starts looking for the forget about it. That picture-perfect drop kick. Wiseguy, a threat absolutely everywhere, in, around, and above the ring.
Wiseguy ran to throw the first punch here in what had been otherwise a relatively clean contest. Wiseguy, though, is prone, getting frustrated. Damian Drake with that speed.
Right, and it looks like that added size hasn't compromised his athleticism at all.
Not.
There's a front handspring back up to his feet. Blocks a series of strikes. The drop kick from Damian Drake, and Wiseguy may want to rethink his strategy.
Wiseguy, though, smartly rolling out. Damian Drake building that pace. Like you said, Wiseguy's very adaptable. He can maintain that pace, but is he going to be able to maintain that pace quite as well as Damian Drake? See, Wiseguy already a little rattled from that drop kick.
As he should be. I mean, that drop kick was on point. And again, I wonder if Wiseguy, truly a student of the game, I wonder if he came in here having done his research on Damian Drake and realizing that Drake has put on some size and maybe assumed that it had compromised his athleticism. And if he did, well, you know what happens when you assume. You do it all the time. Face first to the turnbuckle goes Wiseguy.
Wiseguy went back to that right hand that served him so well. Damian Drake, though.
Oh! Forearm to the face, into the cover. One, two, and a short two count. Wiseguy kicking out quickly.
And Wiseguy has not been able to build up ahead of steam. The hometown hero, Damian Drake, managing to outmaneuver Wiseguy every step of the way. I think you're right. For all his strengths, Wiseguy can be arrogant, may not have done his homework.
Oh my God, you see that? Wiseguy on his way down hit Damian Drake with the knee again, and then an amazing leg lariat. Wiseguy, what are you doing? Kyle Newport, no. Give me my pen back. That's my only pen.
Hey, you focus on
one,
the job.
Two, only a one count. Give me that back. Now it smells like him. Ugh.
His cologne's delightful.
It is not.
And Wiseguy with a headbutt to Damian Drake. I think, if Wiseguy underestimated Damian Drake going into this matchup, now that he has control, he certainly will not.
Well, Wiseguy's a smarter competitor than that. Of course, he is also known to let his ego get the better of him. I think that only comes with a and wait a second, Kyle Newport on the outside.
Kyle Newport whispering words of encouragement to Damian Drake.
Oh, is that what he was doing?
How sporting of
him. How 1987 of you.
He's very sporting.
Bobby Heenan would be super proud of you right now.
Oh, thank you. I love Bobby Heenan.
I mean, he's the GOAT, but, like, he's also super shady. There's a scoop.
Watch this.
A slam. Kyle Newport says, watch this.
What? It was a perfect body slam.
It
wrestlers
was
in the
a
back
great body
should be
slam.
Learning from this matchup.
And Wiseguy with a tribute to Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. An exquisitely executed knee drop. One, two, kick out at two.
Right across the bridge of the nose. Wiseguy, everything he does is impeccable. And now that he is in control, commentator's curse, spoke too soon.
Yeah.
But when he is in control, he is capable of executing everything he does to perfection. We haven't seen Damian Drake in some time. Basically seen his countering capabilities.
Out the back, trying for the O'Connor roll. Spinning elbow to the midsection, followed by a European uppercut, striking Wiseguy every which way. Wiseguy, though, just like that, a devastating backbreaker stops Damian Drake dead in his tracks.
So much force on that, it kicked the entire lower body of Damian Drake off the mat. That was giving Smith some extra gusto from the wise guy.
Wise guy. Into the cover, hooks the far leg. There's a two count and no kick out at two.
It's no secret that the wise guy is looking to get in contention for the Best of West Heavyweight Championship. As I alluded to, he keeps getting in his own way with his own poor attitude. But even I can't do much if he keeps winning. Keeps winning, he might earn that opportunity he's been so yearning for.
Well placed. Left hands right to the bridge of the nose, and Damian Drake being held up by the ropes right now. Irish whip out of the corner. Damian Drake, spine first into the buckle.
This guy getting ahead of steam.
Damian caught him.
Walks him all the way to the metal.
T-bone suplex and wise guy on Dream Street.
That is some impressive strength.
Oh, and a knee right between the shoulder blades. Damian Drake is not done. Brain buster, center of the ring, into the cover. One, two, no, right shoulder up at a count of 2 3/4.
Just a fraction of a second away. What impressive resiliency from Damian Drake, though. Managing to catch Wise Guy, get him out of the corner, throw him, and then follow up with a series of high-impact maneuvers. This is a much more serious, much more dangerous Damian Drake than we've ever seen before.
Right hand, or maybe a vicious forearm, couldn't quite tell. It came with such crispness. That was definitely a flipper to the face.
Wise guy with these right hands of his own.
They've off the ropes.
One of his go-tos this matchup.
Drake ducks a clothesline. Into a power bomb. One, two, and no. Left shoulder up.
Spinning blue thunderbomb, disorienting the wise guy, sending the blood to his head. Wise guy, though, such a veteran, still finding the will to kick out in such a devastating maneuver.
Say what you will about Wise Guy's attitude. He is as tough gets, especially here at Best of the West. And Damian Drake looking to fly. And Kyle Newport on the outside once again.
Kyle Newport doing an excellent job.
Oh! Superplex!
That's what good managers do. Create opportunities. Taking the opportunity was all Wise Guy. Great team.
Wise Guy into the cover. This could be it, and no, a kick out. This match continues, and what a banger we have on our hands, and we still have a hell of a long way to go here tonight at Worlds Collide.
Well, we knew this would be a world-class matchup. We can't be surprised at that, but I think it is pretty surprising seeing the growth of both these competitors and seeing what they are willing to fight through for this match.
Absolutely. Wise Guy going for the forget about it. Damian Drake had it scouted. Dragon suplex connecting, misses with the knee. Oh my God, a tiger knee from Wise Guy. Forget about it.
Wise
it
guy.
Is academic. One, two, and three.
Here is your winner, Wise Guy.
One hell of an athletic contest, and Wise Guy with perhaps a harder fought victory than he would have anticipated. Damian Drake, though, a far different Damian Drake than we've seen in the past, gave Wise Guy a damn good run for his money.
Looking forward to hopefully seeing more of Damian Drake in the near future. Wise Guy, said it before, I'll say it again, so talented, so capable, just needs to get out of his own way and learn to play ball. Impressive, impeccable victory for the Wise Guy.
And I'm sure we will not be hearing the end of it if Kyle Newport has anything to say about it.
Best kept secret of wrestling right here, people. Get it right. You got that?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Your referee in charge of the action, Ben Hall. Quick question for everybody. Is it just me, or does Ben look like a thrift store Val Venus?
Yes!
Every time! I had to do it at least once, doesn't it?
Yes! 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 Yes!
The only time I'll bring it up tonight, I promise. Introducing first!
making his way to the ring from San Luis Obispo, California, weighing in at 160 pounds, he is a Best of the West referee, Reed Matthews.
Buddy, you should draw some attention to the officiating here. Former officiate Reed Matthews, one of our wrestlers in this matchup.
And the look on his face tells the story.
And his opponent. Making his way to the ring from Sin City, weighing in at 666 fried donuts, the Warlord of Weird, Sinn Bodhi.
And I think Reed Matthews is quite correct in keeping his distance. He wants the stick. Sinn Bodhi.
I truly appreciate you guys cheering. I love all of you, and I love Las Vegas, and I love wrestling. I promised to do this show. That's why I'm kind of half-cocked with the clown paint, because I gotta go to a rehearsal for my wedding tomorrow. Right on.
Congratulations, Sinn.
I felt like I've been married for a long time, but we've been married, and I'm making it. Mallory and I'm married. Tomorrow she makes me legit. She makes me an honest clown. But tonight, I'm a man of my word. I kept my booking, even though my wife is probably gonna freaking kill me. But we were in Fresno last year, man. You messed around with me, and you cost me a win at Best of the West. I take it very freaking seriously. So, couple birds tonight with one stone. A, I made my booking. I'm a clown of my word. B, hopefully my wife doesn't get slaughtered, doesn't slaughter me. And you, my friend, are gonna learn a freaking lesson.
Bone-chilling words from the Warlord of Weird, Sinn Bodhi, who is legitimately getting married tomorrow, by the way.
We're confident what he's marrying is a human woman, correct?
I think so. I don't know.
That raised a lot of questions for me, the idea of Sinn Bodhi getting married.
I'm pretty sure. We are under... Oh, my God! We are underway, and Sinn Bodhi does not get paid by the hour. He's here to teach Reed Matthews a lesson, and this one got ugly real quick.
Well, for those who might not have seen the event, Reed Matthews kicked away the hand of Sinn Bodhi in a recent matchup.
My God, and welcome to the business, kid.
Sinn Bodhi alleges Reed Matthews fast counted the fall against him and demanded this matchup. And, well, I'm not necessarily opposed to abuse on referees on principle.
No doy. We've seen. Oh, my God! Double chop to the exposed chest and a rake of the back!
Reed Matthews is technically a trained wrestler. He has been training for some time.
Well, he's been training for 2 years, but because of COVID and setbacks and injuries and quite frankly, Best of the West having a shortage of referees. Thanks again, AGB. This is where he's needed right now, but he is on the receiving end of a merciless beating. Compliments of the Warlord of Weird.
They keep quitting. Something about unsafe working conditions. I don't understand.
Something about, I'm amazed you haven't been sued yet.
And those back rakes, those chops. Sinn Bodhi making it clear he's not necessarily out to win or even necessarily beat up Reed Matthews. He's not doing the things that break your body. He's doing the things that just hurt.
I think it's pretty safe to say he's going to win this one. I would be amazed if... I mean, miracles have been known to happen in and around pro wrestling, but this is...
No!
This is hard to watch.
This is not what we call a pick'em.
No.
There's a pretty clear advantage, everything advantage.
What are the Vegas odds on Reed Matthews actually winning this match?
I believe it's somewhere in the lines of 456 billion to one.
Okay. And Sinn Bodhi just having his way with Reed Matthews.
Okay. Come
on. Spicy lunch, boys and girls.
Sinn Bodhi apparently just flatulating in the face of referee Reed Matthews.
Well, it shows you about how seriously... not to say he's not taking this seriously. Please don't kill me, Sinn Bodhi.
Sinn Bodhi's definition of serious is very different from a quote-unquote normal person's
Absolutely.
Idea of serious as he backstrokes his way through life.
Burying his foot in the chest of Reed Matthews.
Not just directly in the sternum. Looking to cave in the sternum.
An awkward landing for Reed Matthews.
Tailbone first.
We're going to be even shorter on referees now. Thanks a lot, AGB. I'm still amazed. HR is going to be furious. We don't have an HR department.
I've known Reed Matthews for some time, and to be frank, he's had this coming. That's part of why I signed on to this.
My little brother who's here for the wedding.
We don't need these editorializing referees.
He was enforcing the rules. Sinn Bodhi didn't like it. And now you're pretty much sending Reed Matthews to his death. Wait a second. No freaking way. He rolled him up. One, two. There's a two count. I'm amazed he got that much. And a clothesline almost decapitating Reed Matthews.
Sinn Bodhi back to his feet before Reed Matthews and just takes his head off. Well, Reed Matthews wants to be a wrestler. That's part of why he got into refereeing, to learn all the aspects, become a more well-rounded wrestler.
He was inspired by the likes of Rey Mysterio. Big fan of Ray growing up, but nothing he can do right now is going to save him from the wrath of Sinn Bodhi.
How many colors do you think his chest and face area will be tomorrow? I'm betting at least six, right?
I would think so.
Identifies as a lion and gets thrown in the freaking lion cage. Reality kicks in.
Wow. Strong words from Sinn. Whoa. Drop toe hold. Drops him into the ropes. I got to give Reed Matthews credit. He is not giving up.
Created some distance. Let's see what he's going to do with it.
Oh. What's the area code for Vegas? Because he just...
702, I believe.
702 to the nose of Sinn Bodhi. Again, shades of Rey Mysterio, as I mentioned earlier.
Goes for a chop. Doesn't get much mustard. There he goes. Reed Matthews firing back.
Another chop. Ducks a clothesline, although Sinn Bodhi may have gotten enough of it. Ducks again. Another chop.
Chopping away at Sinn Bodhi. I don't know if these shots are having quite the same effect, but managing to reel him.
Sinn Bodhi sends Reed into the ropes. Reed ducks the clothesline. Backed into the ropes now. Sunset flip. Rolls him up. One, two. Only a one count that time. Sinn Bodhi misses wildly with the clothesline. Reed rolls him up. One, two that time.
Reed Matthews.
Boot to the midsection. Going for that sunset flip again. Sinn Bodhi looks, I don't think he's going to go.
I think he's caught his balance this time, and now he's just...
He's grabbing on to the invisible something or other. Uh-oh.
This is bad.
Oh, my God. Reed Matthews is looking into the face of fear itself. Dumps him down. Folds him up. This one's over.
Sinn Bodhi put it. That young squirrel tried to wander his way into the lion's cage, and he almost meant to scratch an eye out, but he was definitely eaten.
Yeah, he is lucky that he's not going to be skinned and made a hat for Sinn Bodhi, or maybe one of his new boots. I don't know.
I missed the eve of his wedding.
And he's going back for more rehearsal, I guess. Steps over Reed Matthews. Well, Reed Matthews was just doing his job, but he bit off far more than he can chew. Sinn Bodhi making a statement tonight at Worlds Collide.